Hi! Welcome to Surviving Schizophrenia with Steven. My name is Steven. I hope you're having a wonderful day. Today, my dad is going to talk about what schizophrenia is and some of the cognitive issues that surround schizophrenia. I hope you enjoy.
Welcome back to Surviving Schizophrenia with Steven. I'm Steve, Steven's dad. I'd like to talk about what is schizophrenia. Is it a neurodevelopmental disorder, or is it a neurodegenerative disorder? And I'd like to talk about that in the context of cognition in schizophrenia and cognitive impairment. It's an important topic because I believe that a lot of the fear that is associated with schizophrenia is a lack of understanding or a misunderstanding of the illness. Cognitive impairment is a core feature of schizophrenia. And when we talk about cognitive impairment, we're talking about the ability to think or not think clearly, the ability to recall information, to memorize things, and the processing speed by which one can process information, and also the frontal lobe activity, which is the executive functioning activity of the brain, and that's the ability to plan and execute on that plan. So that is cognition in schizophrenia. And cognitive impairment is a core feature of the illness. You might be surprised to learn that cognitive impairment in schizophrenia is the major cause of disability in the illness, not delusions and hallucinations. Many people think that those positive symptoms of psychosis, delusions and hallucinations, are the cause of major cause of disability in schizophrenia, but that's not the case. The long-term chronic course of schizophrenia and the long-term chronic disability in schizophrenia is cognitive impairment. So when we're speaking about long-term disability in schizophrenia, we're talking about ability to maintain employment or even be employed in the first place, be productive in life, and live independently. Schizophrenia was originally called dementia praecox, or early dementia, and that was a term that was coined in the late 1800s. And it was a recognition that schizophrenia had a degenerative course, that it was a degenerative, neurodegenerative disorder. But schizophrenia is widely considered a neurodevelopmental disorder, which would be related to the development of the brain, not necessarily when someone was born, because the brain develops through early adulthood, actually, into, I think, about 25 years of age, research now has shown. So schizophrenia is widely, again, considered a neurodevelopmental disorder, not a neurodegenerative disorder. Schizophrenia is also considered, though, a neurodegenerative disorder, at least with the onset and occurrence of psychosis, because psychosis is damaging to the brain. So brain studies using MRI show that schizophrenia is progressive, revealing slightly enlarged ventricles, that's the fluid-filled cavities in the brain, and a decrease in gray matter. That shows a progressive brain illness. Research has shown that there is progressive gray matter loss, small amount, and enlargement of the ventricles, which is the fluid-filled cavities in the brain, with the onset of psychosis. And that would suggest that antipsychotic medications are not the cause of the cognitive issues there, or that cognitive or neurodegeneration. Common neurodegenerative disorders are, the most common, I believe, is Alzheimer's disease, and the next most common would be Parkinson's disease. So schizophrenia shares some attributes to those diseases. And it was interesting back in the late 1890s that it was first termed dementia praecox, early dementia, recognizing that there was a progressive neurodegenerative aspect to the illness. The neurodevelopmental disorders, two common ones that are often thought of as neurodevelopmental, would be autism and ADHD, attention deficit hyperactivity disorder. Those are two common neurodevelopmental disorders. And then again, the antipsychotic medications, they treat the positive symptoms of schizophrenia, the psychosis, the delusions and hallucinations, and they're very effective at treating those. And once those are treated, there is a the side benefit is that some of the negative symptoms, which would be the flat effect, the depression, anxiety, those tend to subside somewhat with the as the positive symptoms subside. But the long-term disability in schizophrenia relates to the cognitive impairment. There's no good resolution to that. And that's one area as a father of a son who's had schizophrenia now for almost 11 years. I'm very interested in what the researchers and doctors are doing around the world to try to bring better resolutions to that issue. So to summarize, cognitive impairment in schizophrenia is a core feature of the illness. It is the major cause of disability for those suffering from the illness. And again, disability meaning employment, ability to live independently, and ability to engage in activities that others have normally engaged in that they would have engaged in prior to the onset of the illness. So those are the takeaways. And there's a debate whether it is neurodevelopmental or neurodegenerative, the disorder. It's widely considered neurodevelopmental, but it has aspects that are degenerative. It might be a little of both, but that's what schizophrenia is. And, researchers are working on this, and, we want to support them in any way we can to find better resolutions to schizophrenia. Yeah. So that's about it for this video. And I understand we'll have Stephen on in a follow-up video to this to talk about how he has handled the cognitive impairments that he has experienced with schizophrenia, because he had no early signs prior to age 12, right? His onset was at age 12, which is early onset psychosis, early onset schizophrenia. But Stephen met all of his normal guideposts, so to speak, in development, and with language and motor skills, and we didn't in social activity, and was excelled in school and sports. So this was he got hit with a very serious illness that came on very suddenly and was not on medication prior to the age of 12 when the psychosis hit. So I'm very interested in trying to resolve what happened with Stephen and what has happened to all of those that are suffering from schizophrenia, and looking forward to helping in any way we can to further the research and investigation and motivate researchers around the world to find a resolution to this problem. Thank you, and have a nice day.